Hello friends, myself Amar. Now in this video I will show you how to create a memory efficient list view, as well as I will also discuss how to create a snack bar in Flutter. Okay, let's start. Now this is the beginning. Now in the scaffold section, in the previous video I have shown you how to create a basic list view. Okay, now I will show you how to create a memory efficient list view in Flutter. Let's start. Body. In the body, what I will do, I will use here list view dot. To create memory efficient list view, we need to use list view dot builder. Now here we will use a property item builder. Okay, and here we will pass context and index. Now why I am passing this index, that I will discuss later on. After that, this. Now here what I will do, I will return list style as I have done in my previous video, right? Now here what I will do, here I will use leading, and in the leading I will use circle avatar. In the circle avatar I will use background image, and in the background image I will use asset image images/amar.jpg. okay, now as you can see in the images folder I have kept this image, and the corresponding changes I have made in this pubspec.yaml as I discussed in my previous video. Okay, now here I will use title and in the title I will pass elements are, but here you need to think that this is a long list view, we need some items also to display, right? For that what I am doing, inside this class I am creating a function, and the function name I am giving as generate list item, right? Okay, and the return type of this function I am giving as list of string, because this will return multiple values, right? And here to generate the items, what I am doing, I am creating a variable in the class where, and the variable name I am giving as items. Okay, now what I will do here, I will write items equals to list of string. Okay, dot, we will use a function generate. Here I will write 500, and after that in the lambda expression I am writing I hope you know lambda expression, this, and here I am writing items are dollar of I. Now what this statement or what this function will do, this function will create, let me check one more thing, this is the function widget. Okay, I am creating this function inside the build method, it should be created inside the class. Let me cut it and paste it here, right? Now what this function will do, this generate list item function will generate how many elements? 500 elements. Okay, and what will be the values of those elements? Items are 0, items are 1, items are 2, and so on. Okay, and after that what I am doing, I am just returning this items, right? That's it. Now in the title section, what I am doing, I will print the values returned by that particular function. Which function? Generate list item function. For that what I am doing, in the class I am calling that function, what I will do is that generate list item. Okay, here it is creating some problem. Let me check. In the build method, what I will do, in the build method I will call the function generate list item. Okay, now in the list title, in the title attribute, what I will do, I will use text, and here I will use items, and after that I will pass this index. Okay, the index which I have taken here, right? And here in the trailing I will use icon, then I will write icons dot delete. Okay, that's it, save. Now let me show you whether it is working or not. Now if you can see the output, see all the items are displayed. Now the advantage of this listview.builder method is that it will not load all the 500 elements in the memory at once. It will load only those items which are visible in the screen. Okay, the items which are not visible in the screen will not be loaded into the memory. That is the beauty of this listview.builder method. Okay, now what we want is that whenever I will press on the list view item, at that time a snack bar should be visible. To do that I am using on tap. In the on tap, what I will do, I will generate a snack bar. How to do that? For that I am creating a variable with the name snack bar. Okay, and here I am writing the snack bar. This is snack bar has a property which is called as content. In the content, what I am writing, text, and in the text I am writing, you have pressed plus items of index. Okay, what it will do, suppose I am pressing the first element, then it will print you have pressed item 0. Okay, and let me save this. Now after that, what I will do, you need to display this snack bar, and to display this snack bar we will write scaffold.ofContext. We will use a method showSnackBar, and here I will pass that variable which I have created. Save it. Okay, now the application is running. Let me show you. If you can see item 0, see you have pressed item 0. You can see here, sorry, item 0. See, in the snack bar you are getting the message items 1. See, you have pressed items 1, you have pressed items are 2. In this way you can generate the snack bar. Now suppose here what I want is that you have pressed item 2, and here I want in the snack bar I want another button. Like in Gmail you can check that whenever you delete an email, then you in the snack bar you get an option undo. Okay, how to do that? For that, here we have an attribute which is called as action. Okay, and here we will use a snack bar action. Okay, and in the snack bar action it has some properties like label. Okay, label, and here I am suppose writing undo. Okay, and what will happen whenever you will click on this undo label, for that here we have a method which is called as onPressed. Okay, in the onPressed what I am doing, I am writing debug print, and after that here I am writing you have pressed undo. Okay, put a semicolon here, save. Okay, now the app is running. Click here. Now you can see undo. Now if you click on this undo, let me bring it to this topmost position. Okay, now click here, item 0, items are 1. Now you can see here undo, right? Now suppose I am clicking on this undo, then you can see in the logcat a message should be printed, you have pressed undo. Okay, this is how we can create memory efficient list view and we can create a snack bar. Okay, now for your information, I have created an app Ripples Code which you can find in the Play Store, and all these tutorials you can find in that particular app. Okay, if you have liked my video, please subscribe my channel. Thank you so much.